time has come. You must continue your journey without me.
What are you... What? Master! You can't leave me!
You must believe.
Master!
What's up, guys? PKBTCG here, and welcome back to another video on the channel. Today, guys, is a bit of a sad day for me personally, as both a player and as a content creator, because my favorite deck of all time, Mew VMAX, is soon rotating out of the standard format in April. And I thought it would be cool to make one final video on Mew and kind of just show my final list for this deck. It's kind of gone through so many different iterations. My core concepts have stayed the same. Mew is still a very powerful deck. It's fallen off in popularity, but it's done more than enough to cement itself as one of the best Pokemon decks of all time. And it's defied so many odds, and it's kind of overcome so many challenges. And I just wanted to show off why I love this deck so much in this final video. Now, some of you guys might be very excited for this card to leave. Some might be just as sad as I am. But today we're going to be looking at Mew and what I consider to be Mew's final form. What I think the deck finally it should look like before it's gone forever in the standard format. So the deck isn't too much different than what we've seen before in the past. If you've watched any of my Mew videos in the past, you know that I like to play a whole bunch of different, sort of like, weirder cards. And I'm going to show that off today. So, starting off first, we have our core lineup of Mew V, Mew VMAX, and Genesect V. These are the three crucial Pokemon that Mew decks will need. Of course, our Mew Vs will evolve into our Mew VMAXs. Mew V allows us to search for, use Energy Mix and Psychic Leap, mainly Psychic Leap, and you'll usually use this with Mew VMAX, using Cross Fusion Strike to copy one of our Bench Fusion Strike Pokemon's attacks, or we can use Max Miracle and shred through our opponent. And then we use the Genesect engine with the Fusion Strike system ability to draw a ton of cards every turn. And then we can cross Fusion Strike Technoblast for 210, and then we can ramp it with more damage after that. Oricorio allows us to use the Glistening Droplets attack, which really does come in handy sometimes for sniping, but it's mainly in here for the Lesson and Zeal ability, which reduces damage done to Fusion Strike Pokemon, so all of our Pokemon, by 20, which is really good, especially in a format where, like, every little bit of math counts. This is just really good. Oricorio is just a very niche card that not a lot of people expect, and it's very good to also it also is a really good stall card if you really kind of just need to sit behind something for a turn. Oricorio is your go-to. We are playing one copy of Aizkyu, the Fusion Strike Aizkyu. Aizkyu will be the only Pokemon, because it's a Brilliant Storms Pokemon, will be the only Fusion Strike card that survives rotation, meaning that is the only strike card to survive rotation at all, but it becomes basically useless. Block Slider does 40 damage to one of your opponent's Pokemon for each Fusion Strike energy attached to all of your Pokemon. So that means you use Cross Fusion Strike, Block Slider, and you have 4 on. That means you're doing, quick bit of math, 160 snipe, which is absolutely insane. And then Icicle Missile for 100. We don't really care about that too much. We also have Meloetta in here with the Melodious Echo attack, which allows us to do 70 damage for each Fusion Strike energy attached to all our Pokemon. So that means we can easily do 280 damage if we have all 4 in play. And then we can ramp that up with things like Power Tablet, Choice Belt, things like that. It gets really crazy really quickly. But You can also donk with Meloetta using Melodious Echo and knock out basically anything in the game turn one, which is just really good. Then of course we have our Mew V, VMAX, and Genesect. And then for the trainers, I'm not going to go too deep into each one of the trainers because we have a lot of them, but I'll go over the more noteworthy ones. Battle VIP Pass will also be rotating out of this standard format, thank goodness. But Battle VIP Pass is just it's probably Mew's best friend. And then we also have the Cram-O-Matic in here, which allows us to discard things like Battle VIP Pass when they're not helpful past turn one. And we can basically try and use it as a sort of like four seal stone or quick search. And it's one, thins our hand, and two, it allows us to try and search for any card that we want. We are playing one copy of Escape Rope. Mainly just, it's really good for getting Mew out of the active spot after using Cross Fusion Strike Technoblast, because it doesn't allow Mew to attack, but it also can make some awkward scenarios for your opponent. One copy of Feather Ball is in here, just so that we can grab our Mew V. So we can grab our Mew V and VMAX. One copy of Hisuian Heavy Ball, so that we can get any one of our attackers, mainly focusing on getting things like Oricorio or Ice Q out of our prize cards. This card can be swapped for something else. I just like playing Heavy Ball because it allows me to do a more efficient prize check as well. Two Lost Vacuum, two Nest Ball, four Power Tablet, which allow our Fusion Strike Pokemon's attacks to do 30 more damage, which can ramp up very quickly, and we can do a ton of damage and knock out anything in the game very easily with Power Tablet. We also have two copies of Switch, and then four copies of Ultra Ball. One copy of Collapse Stadium. We mainly use Collapse to discard one of our benched Mew VMAXs. If it's like heavily damaged, we don't want our opponent taking three prize cards, so we can just Collapse Stadium and get rid of all that damage and all that work that our opponent did. One copy of Path to the Peak, which is counterintuitive, kind of, for Mew, but it also stops things like Charizard EX from getting set up, so that's very good. And then we also have one copy of Town Store, because Mew nowadays has a lot of different tool cards it can choose from in order to be able to work around. And if you have a Town Store, you can search for your deck for like four Seal Stone, and then you can basically, Town Store allows you to search for any card that you want, which is really good. Let's see. Two copies of Boss, two copies of Elisa Sparkle, which allows us to search our deck for up to two Fusion Strike Pokemon, and search our deck for Fusion Strike Energy card and attach it to that Pokemon. This allows for donk scenarios and for just huge energy acceleration very quickly, and it's a very useful card in this deck. We have one copy of Iono, two copies of Judge, and one copy of Peony. Now, I have been advocating for Peony basically ever since I built Mew. It was in the original Mew lists. If you look back like 2 years ago when Fusion Strike first came out, Peony was like a card that people were hyping up a lot, but then it just dropped dead. It was gone. And I had been basically saying like, Peony is the secret sauce for Mew. And a lot of people have disagreed with me, which I get why. But I mean, at the same time, you're searching your deck for up to two trainer cards, which can be any two trainer cards. You can get like, I don't know, you can get four Seal Stone and you can get like Battle VIP Pass, or you can get four Seal Stone and just literally anything you want, and then you can just Fusion Strike System for six, or you can just get a massive new hand. Peony is so helpful in so many different scenarios. It's been probably the most pivotal card in a lot of these matches that I've played with Mew before, and it's won me a decent amount of games. So Peony is definitely has been the underrated card in this list, and it's just absolutely insane. If you're not playing Peony in your Mew list, I would recommend at least trying it out. Then after that, we have our tool cards. We have four of them. We have one copy of Box of Disaster, which basically, if we get O-code by Charizards or by like Chien Pao's, that means we don't have to find a damage modifier in order to KO later, or we might have to find one damage modifier, but it helps fix some math, and it also can prevent Roaring Moon from just being able to go Frenzy Gouging and not, or be able to do Calamity Storm and just not get punished for it. It's just, there's a lot of situations where a Box of Disaster can fix a lot of your math, and it also can potentially kind of scare the opponent into maybe saying like, hey, maybe I'll two-shot this Mew instead of going for the one-shot. One copy of Choice Belt. Mew sometimes is just a tad bit short if you're down some power tablets, or if you just don't have them available. So Choice Belt can really help fix the math in the V matchups. And this is also really good for Meloetta donks. For Seal Stone, a lot of lists like to play three, which is ridiculous. As a longtime Mew player, as someone who has played more than my fair share of Mew, you do not need three Forest Steel Stone. I think two is the maximum you should be playing. I'm playing one. Part of that is because this is based off my real life deck, which at the time I only had one Forest Steel Stone. And you don't need more than one. Like, it's just completely counterintuitive. Grandmamatic doesn't discard them anymore since they're now tool cards. And I don't think that it's very useful anymore to have more than two, but I just have one in here because Star Alchemy allows us to search our deck for any card and put it into our hand. And then our special tech card for Charizard specifically is TMD Evolution. And this is really good if we can go TMD Evolution, like something like Judge, TMD Evolution, Path to the Peak. And then all of a sudden our opponent has no way to get their Charizard set up, their Pidgeots, all of that. And we just shut down Charizard completely. It's very useful. It can be used in a lot of like really bad scenarios, or it can just make for a good discard card with like Ultra Ball. And then our energies, we are playing three double turbo energies because Mew VMAX can use them, and then Genesect can retreat them with them, and then four Fusion Strike energy, which prevents abilities from being from affecting our Fusion Strike Pokemon, and then it also it provides any type of energy and can be accelerated with Elisa Sparkle. So this is the list. This is the final version of Mew that I will ever play on the channel. I promise there will be no more Mew videos after this. But let's hop into some games with what I thought for a very long time was the best deck in format, because it definitely was. Now, Mew and I have a long history. I've played Mew since, or have at least tested Mew since day one of Fusion Strike. And I never got all the cards until my Fusion Strike booster box opening, which I still think is the craziest thing that's ever happened to me in Pokemon. Because I pulled the Altart Mew VMAX, an Altart Genesect V, and a Mew V all in the same pack, which is insane. We're not going to go first because we can do Meloetta. But it's a very special deck to me. And oh my goodness, we are going to need to go for Peony, aren't we? We do have Town Store. So this is the good thing, is that Town Store allows us to, Chien-Pao, okay. We can KO the Chien-Pao. We have to be very lucky. If we go Peony, then we can't get, so if we top deck like Battle VIP Pass, we actually can KO the Chien-Pao. We just have to be very lucky on what we top deck. Okay. So, this deck is very special to me. Obviously, right now, this is a bad hand. It's not looking too great, but yeah. They're just going to get all set up and pass. Okay. So, do I go Cram-O-Matic the Cram-O-Matic first? Yeah. Because we can't. Yeah, Box of the Disaster no longer counts as a. Okay, well, we're going to have to go with a backup play, which is why it's available. No. Okay, well, yeah, we scoop. Well, that's unfortunate. That's really stupid. Yeah, no, Smart Tactics did not. It's literally the fact that I prized it.
Ha ha! You can't change the past!
So yeah, the Seal Stone, you definitely should play two. I'm just playing one because I'm so used to only playing one. Which it's totally okay. But I don't know, that's part of what makes this deck so fun. It's like people have been saying that like Mew is way too overpowered. It oppressed the game for way too long. And I definitely agree. This deck was ridiculously overpowered and it dominated the meta for a very long time for good reason. But I think that really it's just because it's a 3-prize 3/10 attacker and it's a psychic type and a Charizard focused meta, it's just really fallen off in popularity. And it's done more than its fair share of winning. It keeps winning events in Europe. like every single European tournament has been like Mew victory, which is ridiculous. I don't think I've ever seen something like that before with any deck. Just Mew winning all the time. Oh my gosh, if we actually are playing Shadow Rider, this is like the good old days. And we actually can get the Oko. We can get a Donk. Oh my gosh, it's Lugia. I mean, we actually can still Oko the Lugia, which is crazy. Wait a minute. Oh, well, we can? We can. Therapeutic energy and pass? No, another Lugia. It's never that easy. Probably Ultra Ball, discard two Archaeops. No. Oof. That's rough for my opponent. If we top deck, excuse me, if we top deck a Fusion Strike energy, then we are basically perfect. Oh, come on. Of course you have the Squawk ability. Of course you have the Squawk ability. So an old deck. So the question really becomes, can you teach an old deck new tricks? And the answer is yes. Yes, you can. This deck has been through so many different versions throughout the years. And oh my gosh. They're going to have at least one Archaeops in that hand. I guarantee it. No, they just have a ton of Lugias that they keep discarding. Yeah, the battle log is here. I mean, we've really seen this game come, I think, like, almost full circle in a sense. Okay, so they passed. I mean, Iono is nice. I do think that we're not going to get the... Yeah, we're not going to get that. So, I think we just go something like this. We're not going to get it. I already know. Not great. Cram the vacuum. Nice. Okay, so we go get battle VIP pass. Which I am going to be completely honest. I'm so ready for this card to leave the standard format. Okay, VIP is going to go and get us another Genesect, and we can go get a Meloetta, I think, because we have two Mews, yeah. We attach the Fusion Strike energy here. I don't want to use the switch just yet. Okay. You do a lot, so... Yeah, if we would have had this sort of setup before, we would have been good. I honestly think 200 if they attach double turbo. If I had placed down Oricorio, this would have been great. Let's just go switch into the other Mew. That's fine. We can draw one more. Okay, the tempting cram the power tablet. Sure, you know what? Well, let's risk it. Look at that. All right, let's go get probably battle VIP pass again. Or we could go get Elisa Sparkle. I honestly don't dislike the idea of getting a Sparkle. And then, yeah, we'll pass. If they do KO the Mew, it will still be on equal prizes. And then we'll be attacking with a one prizer. So I'm not too worried, actually. Capturing Aroma, one of my most hated cards in this game. And of course they get what they want. I never get what I want with Capturing Aroma. They can put two Lugia V on the bench. You could. Wait, why would you... Huh? What? I'm confused. Okay, a Mew EX is completely useless for them. Oh. Party pooper. That's annoying. Two Mew. Yeah, this is not a good hand. We are going to be burning off basically every card here. Are they just planning on reading the wind this turn? Because if they do, that'd actually be great for us. Because we can go get, like, belt or tablet. So this is it? This is all they're playing right now? There's not anything going for them. Like, I don't know. Very weird decision to evolve the bench Lugia. I can see why. But I don't know. It just seemed like a very weird play. I imagine they just read the wind, yeah. They probably have an Archaeops in their hand. Nope. Okay, well, we are actually in a position to win here. The Ultra Ball is actually a really great top deck. So I can go Mew VMAX. I can Ultra Ball. What's in our... Yeah, no, we have all the Pokemon in here. Let's go get you, I guess. Just get another basic. Do something like this. Evolve. I want to save the switch in case we have to use Techno Blast. Okay, the Seal Stone allows us to, I think, guarantee it. We just can't draw into it. I can go ahead and use Town Store, because I don't imagine them playing any other really noteworthy. Box of Disaster is great. Or actually, no, Choice Belt. Choice Belt gets us the knockout, right? No, it doesn't matter. We already have... Oh, you see, I that was a misplay on my part. We could have actually gone one on Mew. Yeah, now let's go get the Box of Disaster. In case they somehow get an Oko. Cramomatic the Nest Ball. Okay, Cram did not want to work that time. Which is okay. We'll go Box. I'll just go ahead and use Star Alchemy right now. So that way we guarantee it. I'll use the Sparkle, and I'll just go on to two VMAXs. Because, I mean, I guess if we need to use Block Slider later on, definitely a bit of a misplay. I'm a bit rusty. But we can just go ahead and Fusion Strike System for a ton more cards. Solid. Cram the VIP. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're doing 280. Okay, cool. So what do we get here? I would say probably Rope wouldn't be too bad, but Boss is probably better, because we're going to just be able to outpace them in the prize race. Yeah, just a Melodious Echo. Boom. And two prizes for us. Looking really good here. I honestly wouldn't mind, wouldn't really care about a Judge or an Iono, but I don't imagine them playing that many. Burnett is not either of those, so I know that this Meloetta is going down, but, oh, we would have gone for, like, Peony or something? Nah, Snorlax. No, we're gonna just be able to get the Mew up, which is good, and then just Boss for another one. Like, this is probably the best play they have. Reversal? What the... What? You're telling me you're gonna attack with this thing? I'm sorry, that... Huh? What? Is this like Reversal? Lugia, where it's like the Luxray or whatever. No. What is this? What am I looking at? Whatever, man. I mean, I still win the prize race. There's no way for them to be able to... Because I'm not going to play Collapse. There's no point in me playing Collapsed anymore. Yeah, the V-Guard is going to offset the Choice Belt. Which is fine. So you're going to go for the 200. Yeah. 180. And, oh yeah, that's right, they can discard the Town Store. That's lame. Alright. Let's go up here. So I believe we do get a knockout. Oh, we did not need to draw into that. I mean, it does. So I think we go Ultra Ball away Judge. And TMD Evolution. Go get a Meloetta. Place that down. Feather Ball. Fail. Boss Mew EX. I honestly don't really mind using the switch now, because I still have free retreat. Okay, there's the double turbo that we needed. You can save the power tablet in hand, because I'm doing 190. Ultra Ball these two. I know they're not going to be helpful at all. And we will not grab you. You're not helpful. Also, this is like kind of thinning to Iono proof a little bit. That's fine, I guess. But we want to keep those. So let's just go Cross Fusion Strike Techno Blast. Techno Blast, boom, get rid of you. And then we have the game-winning boss. And the double turbo right away. The path would have been helpful at the beginning of the game, but it's not really that helpful in this matchup in general. So, if our opponent takes out this Mew and doesn't find a way to get rid of the Squawk ability, we just win. So they're just, I don't know what this is. I honestly don't understand what this is, or not that, what. I can't look at the reversal wallet. That's a little lame, but that's fine, I guess. If they hit with the Snorlax, then they just lose. They're just trying to set up all the Snorlaxes. They need an Iono in order to, stay in the game, even. Nope, GG. Bye-bye. You poor soul. You never stood a chance. And let's just spam the power tablets. Give me that. And bye-bye. Cross Fusion Strike. Techno Blast, and we will take our last two prizes and basically completely avoid that Lugia V-Star altogether. And yeah, the last two Genesects, which were prized. Awesome. So that's kind of what Mew is supposed to do. Like, that was a much better game than game one. I think we should probably try and get one more win. So let's try and get one more win with this deck, because it really does mean a lot to me. And it's been so much fun to play throughout the years. And I don't know, I have mixed feelings about this rotation. Mainly, my biggest grievance is that we lose this deck. And I know I've said that a lot. No, we've been able to choose second every time. Which our opponent's probably going to be very confused when they see, like, oh, Mew, what the heck? Why did they choose to go second? And oh my, this is the perfect hand. And they have to take Mulligan card. Oh, okay. Well, this might be one of those like weird. Okay. What is it? Esperatha. This might be like an Esperatha deck. I have no idea. Like mini Shadow Rider, but who knows? If they don't get another Pokemon, we win. Oh, please don't have anything other than that not to. Please, I'm begging you. Just have the not to. No! Okay, well, we're going to have to drag this game out a bit. If they get a Flittle, that means that they're playing Esperatha. I don't care about Esperatha because Mew has Max Miracle, which literally just shreds through their immunity. Oh, yeah, no. Mimikyu also, we just shred through their immunity with Max Miracle. So we don't care about Mimikyu at all. Oh, we can actually use Artisan too, which is... They are literally only helping... Yes, I knew it. I knew it was the Esperatha deck. Because, yeah, this is it. We're golden. We literally just win with using Max Miracle the whole time. So our opponent is definitely getting a little set up. Ooh, they chose to discard a research. They probably have stuff going on in their hand. But I mean, this hand is just way too good. Like, this is just, there's so much going on. You can't... If you send up the Mimikyu, you're just, yeah, that's not good for them. Okay, first off, we're going to use Artisan, and we're going to go get ourselves... we could even use Ice Skew. I actually don't dislike using Ice Skew. Yeah, well, you know what? Why not? I never use Ice Skew. So, let's just go two of these guys. Boom. Fusion Strike Energy. Sparkle. These two. Solid. We have... Everything is going right now. And do I even want to... I guess we can go... The tablets aren't even going to matter in this matchup. Like, we don't even need to use power tablets. So we'll just get rid of that. We don't even need power tablets. So we can just draw. Cram the Ultra Ball is risky, but we're going to take... That is a risk that I'm willing to take. And that is why it's super worth it. So I think we go with another Mew and we go for we have to go for battle VIP. Whoops, I kind of skip steps sometimes. So I think we literally just automatically win the game. Like, I don't see a way for our opponent to even get set up without us just obliterating. So let's go system, draw four more cards. Yeah, this looks pretty much like game over. So the question is, do we get rid of the Flittle or do we get rid of the Mimikyu? Or, so I think we just go and get rid of the 120. Yeah, just get rid of that. Goodbye. And off it goes. They probably have Tulip or something, but I don't really mind. Also, their damage is reduced because of Oricorio, so that's very nice. I just don't see what they can do. To be honest, thinking about it, we probably should have gone after the Flittle because we could have just gone with the Ice Skew. Wait, they're willingly putting down a two-prizer. I mean, they just made that way easier. I imagine they are going after research or something. If they do, then, like, why didn't you just discard the Luminion before? Because now you just gave me a free two-prizer, dude. Yeah, I don't understand. Also, they don't... I guarantee they're not expecting for me to just be able to go Mew VMAX and Max Miracle on their Esperatha. There's another Flittle. Oh, it's the EX. Uh-oh. Oh, well, that's a little frustrating. Oh, their ability doesn't work. That's right, their ability doesn't work.
Wait a minute. This is actually just so good.
Fusion Strike Energy turns off their ability. Ooh. Nice. Wait, what? Hold on, I missed that. Let me look at the battle log, because that's actually there. Oh, and I already saw a Drew Peony. Okay. Okay, and then we go VMAX, and we go VMAX. We can actually not... I don't think we can get rid of this thing right now. If I went boss, Ultra Ball, the VMAX, and the Meloetta. And then we just tried to get... Yeah, if I went boss, Luminion. Because it's only to... Oh, nice. Okay. So 120. So we don't need those two. Fail it. Solid. There's the switch and the double turbo. Yeah, we can go like this. Keep the ice cue safe by... Oratorio actually came in clutch. I just realized that. Like, it didn't clock in until right now. No, we're good. Okay, there's the other Fusion Strike energy, so we can, like... Now we can go Meloetta once one of these Pokemon goes down. I think we just go Cross Fusion Strike. Yeah, we just go Cross Fusion Strike, Techno Blast, take two prizes, and we are basically in the driver's seat here the rest of the game. I don't see how our opponent wins this. Yeah, that's what I expected. Because 220, if we are actually able to draw into our last two power tablets, we just win. Like, we get rid of their EX, it's over. We've only used one boss, we still have escape rope. There's still so many different options left for us. They have, like, none. So... Yeah, okay. There's the single prize Esperatha, like I thought. Done to this Pokemon. They might actually try and retreat. If they do, then they're a fool. The Thornton. Okay, Thornton's actually kind of cheeky, but... They might just try and go Esperatha. And try and sit behind that. If they do, then that's perfect. I actually would prefer if they try to do that. Is actually just super big brain of me. But let's see what they do. Because they don't have a tulip in their discard pile. I think they're debating whether they want to try and just keep immunity, which they probably don't understand that Max Miracle. Yep. Yep, they're going for it. They're going for it. They have no idea. And we actually... I feel so bad. I feel actually really bad because they have no idea. Oh, put your Mimikyu back in the deck. Yeah, it's not going to matter. I can also just Ice Cube. I can just block Slider. But I actually want to keep that. Slowpoke? What's a Slowpoke for? What the... What? Oh my gosh, okay. All right, buddy. Here's what we're gonna do. There's so much that we can do with this hand. Oh wait, hold on. We don't even have to worry about this Esperatha. We can just not care about it. I think we just go something like this. Yeah, but you're just going for after the Shadow Rider. I don't know why you'd put that down, dude. Because now I just win. Yeah, let's just get rid of these two. Because I know I'm not going to need either one of them. Nothing. Boss this up. They haven't taken a single prize yet. This is not how I imagined the final game recording on the channel for Mew would be. But yet, here we are. I don't want to play anything else. Let's just go Cross Fusion Strike, Techno Blast. Why are we doing 210? Is there something that's like making me do less damage or something? Because last I checked, Techno Blast is 220. Oh, it is 210. I don't know. Power Creep is a very weird thing, ladies and gentlemen. And so yeah, now they're going to sit with their Esperanza thinking, oh, I'm safe. I'm safe behind this Esperanza. No, you're not. I have the Peony. I have the Peony in order to get the at least two of the power tablets, and then I'll just draw back up. It's over. Or if you go after another Pokemon. Nope, probably just gonna go Psyball. If that's the case, then we just go Peony for Escape Rope, because I believe that's in the deck, and then we win. So let's see what they do. Yeah, we just absolutely beat the crap out of this deck. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, okay, well, this is the... Huh? Why would you put the Esperanza into your hand? So you can use... Oh, you can't even use Twilight Inspiration. Interesting. Okay, well, GG. It's over. There is a tablet. Well, let me go cram the cram first. Tails, all right. I don't know. We can just attach the belt here. It doesn't matter. Peony, I think, is good. Yeah, here. Peony. We just need that good old escape rope. All right, who are you putting up? Who's losing you the game? I actually could have just gone Block Slider now that I think about it. Goodbye. And that, my friends, is just the power of Mew VMAX. You saw that they didn't take a single prize card that entire time. And a lot of the stuff actually in that matchup worked out perfectly. In the final two matches really just showed we have basically what Mew defines Mew. We had the bad starting hand with Genesect and bad luck with the Cram-O-Matic RNG. Then we had two games where Mew just destroyed. And that's really what I think Mew is able to do. Is that if in the format that it was in all the formats it's been a part of, it's been a hit big or go home. Like, it's really been a RNG sort of deck. Sure, you can draw all the cards in the world, but at the end of the day, if you're not drawing the specific cards you need, you're not going to be able to win. And people think Mew is a brain dead deck. And I'm sorry, I'm kind of going on a tangent a bit here, but Mew requires so much thought to it, like, especially in those really nail biting situations, and especially when it's countered all the time by like a million different things. So I think that's the perfect place to wrap it up for Mew VMAX. It's been a pleasure being able to cover this deck multiple times for you guys on the channel. Mew has won me my biggest tournament win ever. It really has meant a lot to me. So this one's for you, Mew. I really appreciate you guys watching the video and just supporting the channel in general. Rotation's right around the corner, so we're paying our last respects, 07s, for our Mew compatriots. And yeah, that's going to wrap it up for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. As always, God bless, have fun, we'll see you out there, and we'll see you next time. Thank you all so much for watching. All hail Lord Mew.
Lodius Echo for 210. Let's go, baby. Let's go. That is why Mew is just so much fun.
Moving the Mew VMAX into the active spot, and boss's orders brings up the Zacian V, Vance Kelly, the 2023 Pokemon TCG World Champion!